Eugenie Sage.
I'm pleased to take a call on the South Taranaki District Council Coal Creek Water Supply Bill. And particularly pleased because some of the statements from government members indicate that the government is very worried about a Labor-Green government in 2014. I look forward to being part of that government. And I think the one thing I do agree with Dr. Smith about is that this bill brings to bear some of the issues of principle, which are one of the reasons we're opposing this government, because it's all about a privatisation agenda. And it's fascinating being in Select Committee and having what seems like a small local bill come along which throws into relief these big issues of principle about privatisation of community assets, especially essential community assets around water. So certainly congratulate Chester Burrows for his very good work as a local member in bringing the bill to the committee. The Green Party supported it at the first reading in accordance with the convention to support local bills, but it's been the further information that's come through the Select Committee process, through public submissions, that means we won't be supporting the bill at this reading and subsequent readings. Mr. Speaker, this bill is needed because those wanting the bill need it, in order to transfer ownership of the small-scale water supply scheme which was built in the 1980s to rural landholders in the area, and there are about 160 dwellings and about 400 people. And the water supply is used primarily for farming purposes. One of the reasons we oppose it is because the Local Government Act 2002, and one of the areas which the government hasn't amended, thankfully, contains quite explicit provisions which restrict local councils from disposing of infrastructure necessary for providing water services in their district. And so without this local bill, the council couldn't divest itself of the scheme because the number of households that the scheme serves exceeds the threshold in the Local Government Act. So, Mr. Speaker, this, as other speakers such as Annette King have mentioned, the desire by the scheme users to divest the scheme goes back to the early 1990s. But then they were very concerned that future councils would corporatise or franchise the scheme. Those fears haven't been realised. So we don't see why there is a need to privatise the scheme. And that's because there has been quite significant public funding of the scheme. There was a 1984 Crown grant of $1.28 million, which met half of the construction costs. And also, I understood from the submissions presented by the South Taranaki District Council that there'd been an effective ratepayer subsidy for some of the scheme's operation costs as well. But one of the major reasons the Green Party is now opposing the bill is because of these strong submissions by iwi and the potential injustice which the privatisation would result in. There was a submission from the Taranaki Nihi Kiwaitotara Incorporation, and they were very concerned about the privatisation affecting the value and the potential rental return from their leases in perpetuity over Māori reserve land in the scheme area. Because the scheme infrastructure, the headworks, the reticulation network are all improvements. So in terms of privatising the scheme, the value of those improvements is not reflected in the rental value of the land which is on this perpetual lease. So they were also concerned, and this one's even more serious, that there would be quite a lot of uncertainty over whether water from the scheme would be available to their lands in future. Because as the incorporation noted, a number of waterways in Taranaki are already under pressure in dry periods during the summer, and many rivers and streams are fully allocated. So some of the leaseholders who are leasing land from the incorporation on a perpetual lease also own blocks of freehold land. The incorporation was concerned that the current water permits issued by the Taranaki Regional Council might be transferred from the leasehold land to these freehold blocks, and so the incorporation's land would potentially in future no longer have a certain access to water through the water permits issued by the council. So they made some suggestions about how the legislation could be amended to provide certainty that these their Māori reserve lands would have the certainty of access to water. The Select Committee did not accept those amendments. Given that the land was first confiscated, then went on perpetual lease to the was given as Māori reserve land for perpetual leases, there is potentially a major second injustice caused by this legislation if there is any risk of Māori reserve land being denied water permits in future. So that's one of the reasons we are opposing it. And Dr Smith, as is often a characteristic of Dr Smith, promoted a lot of misinformation about the other reason we are opposing the bill, and that's in relation to the referendum. We have never proposed that there be a referendum over the whole of New Zealand as to whether the scheme be divested. It is a referendum over the whole of South Taranaki District that we propose. The bill, as it's amended in Select Committee, only provides for a referendum over the scheme area, an area that could be served by the scheme. So it's over a very small part of the district, not over the whole of the district, which is what the Green Party supported, because we want, given the public money that has gone into the scheme, all of the district to be involved in that referendum. But it is typical of the National Party, and we've seen that too in the changes to the Local Government Act and the withdrawal of the mandatory referendum on any reorganisation proposals, that they want to restrict the number of people who have an ability to vote. So for those reasons, Mr Speaker, the very narrow area that the referendum's being would be conducted over, the fact that there is a potential second injustice to Māori landholders from the proposal, and thirdly, that substantial public money has gone into constructing the scheme. It's been subsidised by ratepayer funds, so it and had a major investment of taxpayer revenue, $1.8 million. Thank you, Ms Barry. The scheme should stay in council ownership. The council is quite capable of administering it, managing the scheme for the benefit of the users, not privatising it and seeing those users get potentially quite significant private benefits given the enormous value of water, particularly in summer dry periods. So for some of those reasons, Mr Speaker, the Green Party will be opposing the bill.
Jackie Dean.
Thank you, Mr Speaker. I'm very happy to speak on the South Taranaki District Council Cold Creek